What's going on, y'all? The Brandon Brownson here, and I just wanted to do a quick video about a gaming news article that I read a little while ago. If you're not interested in gamer news, you might as well go do something else, because this video is not going to interest you in the slightest bit. So I just got done watching the Philip DeFranco show. Rip on me all you want. Yeah, I watched the Philip DeFranco show. But I digress. I was watching the Philip DeFranco show, and he did this news article that comes from EdgeOnline.com. I'll have a link down there in the crotch bar for you. Anyways, this article had a bunch of information about the new Xbox. Just for the sake of argument, let's call it the Xbox 720, since that's what a lot of fans are already calling it. It says a bunch of information about the specs in the game. They're going to be on 50GB high-capacity Blu-ray discs. All sorts of technical mumbo-jumbo like that that I'm not really interested in, but I'm sure some gamers are going to be growing immense hard-ons about. But the reason why this article interested me is because of one little detail and one big detail. Now, the little detail says that the console will need a constant internet connection in order to function. Now, this is an issue for me because I don't have money for my own internet. Whenever I use the internet, I'm either at a friend's house, at a place that has free public internet, or stealing a neighbor's Wi-Fi, which is how I upload and do most of my videos. All the direct uploads, that's me stealing a neighbor's Wi-Fi. If I'm going to need a constant internet connection to even play my fucking system, I'm probably not going to purchase this system. However, that's not even the main thing that got to me. The main thing that rustled my jimmies, you guys really like it when I use that phrase, so I'm gonna start saying that more. The main thing that rustled my jimmies is that each game is going to come with an activation code. You will have to put this code in if you want to play the game, and the code only works once. In layman's terms, that means that whenever you want to play a new game that you don't already have, you're going to have to go out and buy a physical copy of the game. Or download it. There's rumors that there's going to be a Steam-like thing. I digress. This is an issue because this basically eliminates the video store's gaming sections and services like Gamefly. This makes it to where you can't borrow a game from a buddy. And this kind of kills stores like GameStop, who get most of their service by buying used games and then reselling them. We can talk all day about how GameStop are kind of assholes when it comes to that, but that's not important to what I'm trying to say. There's two big issues with this. First things first, I and a lot of my gamer friends don't have a lot of money. We can't go out and buy a $60 brand new game, or however much these games are going to cost now that they're beefing everything up, which is probably going to be closer to $65-$70, just kind of guessing there. We can't go out and spend that much money on a game. What we can do, we can borrow a game from a friend, we can go out to a video store and rent it, we can use a service like Gamefly. Or what most of my buddies do is they go out and they buy a used copy of the game. This is keeping it to where gamers can't game, at least not on this system. The other big issue with it, and this is a pretty big issue, I went out and bought a lot of the games that I own because I borrowed them from a friend and wound up really liking the game. Or I rented it from a video store and really liked the game and decided that that game was worth purchasing. That is kind of killing buzz around games. There's a lot of sleeper hits out there that end up getting popular because someone went out and rented the game and thought, holy shit, this is a pretty fucking cool game. I should go buy it. It's eliminating almost like a free version of advertising. They might not get all of the money at, like, the start, but more people will go out and buy the game because they've rented it or because they borrowed it and they enjoyed it. But my main issue with it is the fact that it eliminates the way that I get my hands on any percent of the games I've ever played in my life. I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt that if this type of system would have been implemented a long time ago, I would have never become a gamer, because I didn't have the money back then, and I don't have the money now to go out and buy a brand new system, or buy a brand new game every time I want to play a game. A lot of us don't have that 60, 70 bucks to just freely spend. So that's kind of my little rant on that. I'd like to know what you guys think of the story. Again, there'll be a link to the story down there in the crotch bar, along with all sorts of other stuff, such as a link to go download my EP, and the Chameleon Couch Productions Facebook page, which you guys should totally go and apply to join. I say apply because it's a group, and yeah, anyways, I digress. That about does it for this video. Remember, leave a comment, let me know what you think of this story. Do you agree with me? Do you think that this is going to hurt the new Xbox? Or do you think I'm completely in the wrong? Do you think that this is what Xbox needs to do? Leave a comment, like, comment, subscribe. That about does it for me, though. The Brandon Bronson, signing out.